Now let's see about intermediate code for switch statement or translation of switch statement. We know what is the use of switch. Switch is mainly useful when we have a number of choices, and if we want to select one choice among the list of choices, then we use a switch. This is the syntax for switch, and this is nothing but intermediate code or translation of switch statement. First let's see the syntax for switch statement. Here E stands for expression. Here it may be either integer expression or some character expression. So after evaluating this expression, it may produce an integer value or character as the result. Here v1, v2, vn minus 1, these are nothing but case values. These values may be either integer values or some character constants. S1, S2, Sn minus 1, Sn. This is nothing but statement block. It contains a set of statements. First here, the expression will be evaluated. If the expression matches with case value v1, then the corresponding statement block, that is S1, will be executed. If expression result matches with v2, then the corresponding statement S2 will be executed. If the result of expression matches with vn-1, the case value vn-1, then the corresponding statement block sn-1 will be executed. Here, after the statement block, we may need to use a break statement. If we don't use break statement, then the remaining cases will also be executed. Okay, so it is our choice. If we want to execute a number of choices, then it is no need to use break statement. Whereas if you want to select only one choice, then after the statements we need to use break. So whenever break is executed, then the control comes out from the switch. If the expression doesn't matches with any case value, then the default block will be executed. So what is the default block here? The statement block SN will be executed. So when default will be executed, if the expression doesn't matches with any case value. In switch, default is optional. It is not compulsory. Okay. So this is the syntax for switch. Now let's see the translation of switch statements. So first one, code to evaluate e into 2, t. So first here, the expression will be evaluated, and after that, the corresponding result is stored in a variable called t. So t stores the result of the expression. Next one, go to text. So whenever this one is executed, then the control goes to the label text. Here we have text here. So the control will be transferred here now. So in text block, this is nothing but label here. So text colon. If t is equal to v1, here t means expression result. So this expression result is available in t now. If this expression result matches with v1, if t is equal to v1, so v1 is nothing but case value, whereas t is nothing but result of the expression. So if t is equal to v1, then we have to execute s1 here. So we need to go to l1 here. So the control will be transferred to l1 here. Okay. So in l1, what is the code here? Code for s1. So that is the body we have written here. If expression value, if expression result matches with case value v1, then s1 has to be executed. That s1 code is available in the label l1. So code for s1. So s1 code will be executed, and after that go to next. So the control will go to the label next colon. So in next we don't have any statement, so the control will come out from this switch here. So here we don't have any statements in the next, so it works as break statement. Okay, so for break statement we use this next here. Okay, so whenever this one is executed, then the control comes out, then the control goes to the label next colon. Here we don't have any statements, so with this that execution will be over. Okay, so next one, if expression value t matches with if t is equal to v2. If t is equal to v2, then we have to execute s2. But s2 block code is available in l2. So go to l2. So control will goes to l2 now. So in l2 we have code for s2. Next go to next. So control goes to next label. So likewise, if t is equal to vn minus 1, if t is equal to vn minus 1, then go to ln minus 1. So control will be transferred to l minus 1 now. So here we have a code for s minus 1. So this is the code here. After that, go to next. So control goes to next. Here, if the expression doesn't matches with any case value, that means t doesn't matches with v1, t doesn't matches with v2, t doesn't matches with vn minus 1, then what will happen? Sn will be executed. So go to ln. So control will goes to ln now. So here there is no need to write any condition here. If the previous conditions are false, then it will be executed. So here, what is the code here? Code for, we need to execute S1 body here, S1 statements here. So code for Sn, next go to next. So control will goes to next here, okay. So likewise, we can write the intermediate code for switch statement.